So today we're going to go through, as it says on screen, how to develop a system that truly serves your needs. So this is about how do you establish a spare parts management system that will serve the purposes of what you're trying to achieve. And that thing of what people are trying to achieve does tend to vary. So we all have sort of different goals and aims with our spare parts management. But if you do what I'm going to talk through today, I'm very, very, very confident that you will achieve that system that serves your needs. So let me just get that started. So I'm a big fan of Stephen Covey and the 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. There's an image of the book on the screen. And particularly I'm a fan of habit number 2, which is begin with the end in mind. For some people, begin with the end in mind is all about having some sort of big vision about things, and that's all very good. But I think to me, it's about just trying to understand what it is you're trying to achieve, and how will you know when you've made some success? How will you know what your goal is? It's about understanding that goal and being able to say, right, here's where we're trying to drive to, and therefore being able to say, are our actions continually taking us in that direction? For those of us who are more visually oriented, here's a chart of a 49% inventory reduction with a company that I was able to track their data for nearly 4 years. And so we can see here that whilst it took them somewhere in the region of 20 months before they really, you know, continually went down, then it started to level off. The important thing there was that even after another couple of years, it didn't jump back up. It didn't all go back on the shelf. And that's about longevity. Here's a smaller inventory reduction that happened in a shorter time frame, so 37% inventory reduction. That's often what people are after. Oh, and I've missed one. There's a 54% inventory reduction that was achieved with a pretty steep fall after a couple of months, and then it was leveling out. So I look at this, I'm thinking, okay, we can see that if these are the sorts of goals we have, then we can start making sure that what we're putting in place is driving us towards these sorts of outcomes. The question that I then have is, how did the people that we've just seen achieve the transformation in their spare parts management? And the answer to that really is by adopting a different approach to how they manage their inventory. So there is the classic definition about what is madness. It's about doing the same thing, expecting a different result. And so what I'm going to be saying to you today is that you need to be thinking differently about how you manage your spare parts, because if what you're doing so far isn't working, you probably need to change and do something different.